Hello everyone, my name is Jessica Goble and I am the Director of Children and Family Ministries at Onalaska United Methodist Church. Welcome to our annual KidMin Christmas pageant. This year we had 12 families video 12 scenes to put together for the pageant. The scenes bounce back and forth between a bedtime story and telling of the nativity story out and about. So, here we go. Enjoy.
Oh, there's no place like home for the holidays. 'Cause no matter how far away you roam.
And they all lived happily ever after. The end. That was a good one. Okay. Good night, Abel. Good night, Eden. Night, Brad. Love you.
Wait, Grandma. Don't leave yet.
Why?
Can't you stay a little while?
Why? What's the matter?
That book made me afraid.
The bear who slept through Christmas? Like what?
Well, let's see. There's airplanes, bees, coronavirus, dogs, electric shock, fire, ghosts, hexes, invertebrates, judgment, knives, lice, mice, nighttime, orthodontist, poison, questions, roller coasters, spiders, teasing, under my bed, violence, worms, x-rays, yellow fever, and Zoom.
One.
Go. Did you just list all your fears in alphabetical order? Oh my gosh, that is amazing. I can relate sometimes. I feel afraid. Sorry.
How am I supposed to sleep now? I can't sleep when I'm afraid.
Well, sometimes stories help me when I'm scared. When I'm afraid or I'm worried, I remember that I'm a part of a bigger story that is bigger than myself. Oh, God's story is full of people who were sometimes afraid. You know, I think I have time to tell you one more story. This part of God's story is during a time when many people were afraid of many things, just like you, Abel. It all begins in Nazareth, a town of Galilee, with a woman named Mary.
Oh. Hi. Welcome. Welcome to my home. Do you want to talk to me? We haven't met before, have we? Do you want to hear what I have to say?
I do. Pardon me. Let me start over. Greetings, favored one. God is with you.
What kind of greeting was that?
Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you are going to have a baby boy. You will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and his kingdom will have no end.
How can this be? How is this going to happen?
The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called the Son of God. Also, your relative Elizabeth is going to have a baby, even though people thought it would be impossible. For nothing is impossible with God.
Is that all a question?
Oh,
Elizabeth! Are you home? I'm coming in!
Come in, Mary! Mary, I have something to tell you. You are so blessed among women, and the baby in your womb is also blessed. The moment the sound of your greeting entered my ears, the baby in my womb leaped for joy. Here, feel it.
Elizabeth, I'm also bursting with good news. God took one good look at me, and look what happened. I'm the most blessed woman on earth. What God has done for me will never be forgotten. I'm talking about the God who knocked the power off their friends and lifted up the lonely. So, can I stay with you for a few months?
Mary is pregnant? How is this possible? We're not even married yet, and the law says this isn't good. Not good at all. She claims that this child, the child she's carrying, is actually God's child. My only option is to marry her and then divorce her quietly. That will save my reputation at least. But she will be so disgraced. I don't know what to do, and I'm afraid. Oh, Mary.
Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to get married. God's Holy Spirit has made Mary get pregnant.
She will have a son, and you will name him Jesus. God saves because he will save his people from their sins.
I'm gonna marry Mary, and we're gonna have a son and name him Jesus, and I'm gonna be the dad. I need to pack.
Is terrific. Oh, there's no place like home.
Hold on. I have questions. Why is Joseph packing a bag? Why was Joseph afraid about Mary having a baby? Do angels still visit people in dreams? Why did Mary stay at Elizabeth's house? Who names a kid God saves? Why is everyone making such a big deal about this? It's just a baby. This story is so weird.
I don't know the answers to most of those questions. This is a bigger than life kind of story, and there are a lot of unexplainable and miraculous parts.
That sounds like what Pastor Park says when I ask tough questions.
Good. I'm glad I sound like Pastor Park because we just don't have all the answers. Now I do know the answers to one of those questions. Why is Joseph packing to understand that we need to meet the emperor?
Citizens of Rome, it is I, your Lord and Savior, Good Shepherd, Light, Way, the Prince of Peace, Caesar Augustus. First, I want to say you're welcome for all the great things I've done for you. There has never been an emperor as powerful and glorious as me. My empire is vast. You people are obedient. I'm saving you all. You owe me so much, so much. citizens, I want to count you. Let's get a good head count so that you can all pay me what I am owed. Go to your hometown and register your family so that you can show proper appreciation for my awesomeness. I decree it to be so. Farewell, my faithful children. May you know my magnificent ways. Farewell.
Okay, the good news is I think we found a place to stay.
Finally, this baby's not gonna wait much longer. Where are we staying? Oh, did you get a room at the nice inn I like? The one with the good breakfast?
Not exactly. It was full.
Oh no, what are we going to do? Sleep outside with shepherds? Stay in a stable with donkeys?
What? No, why would we do that?
Joseph, this baby's coming soon.
I know. The guest rooms are all full, but I found an innkeeper who will let us stay in a small space in his home.
Oh, good.
Yeah, it's a small space with lots of hay and maybe a few animals.
Hello, donkey.
Man who lives in Tennessee.
Stop there.
What? Why?
I don't think I want to hear about the birth part.
Okay, we can talk about that later. The Bible doesn't really tell us anything about the birth anyway. It just says that Mary had the baby and wrapped him in strips of cloth and put him in a feeding trough. That's it. But those are important details to remember for the next part of our story. It takes place in a field.
Okay, keep going.
There were shepherds living outside the fields nearby, watching over their sheep. They were about to be frightened by some powerful messengers from God, but they would soon realize they did not have to be afraid.
Afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. There will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in clothes, lying in a manger. Good news for all the people. The Messiah is born, a Savior. Glory to God in the highest. And on earth, peace among those whom God favors. That is all. Bye-bye.
So, you both saw that, right?
Yeah, I did.
Yep, that happened.
Well, we are going, right? Yes, we are going. We have to go.
Do we bring the sheep?
Yeah. Me want to come. Take me with you.
What were those signs again?
A baby. Wrapped in strips of cloth. Lying in a manger.
We won't forget. Let's go.
You two sheep, come along.
You gotta leave your sheep, leave your rest.
That was a miracle.
It was exactly how the angel had described. The baby was wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger.
Friends, we have seen something amazing tonight. I don't know about you, but it feels like the world is changing. Yeah, but why do you think we got to see it?
Stop it!
Nobody cares about us. Shepherds, we're poor and we don't have very much power.
I have no idea, but the baby's mother, Mary, acting like this was supposed to happen, like this was meant for people like us. Maybe this baby will lift up the lowly.
And bring down the lofty. Wouldn't that be something? It sure would. I believe there is no limit to what this baby can do.
Hey, shepherds, was that star there last night? I don't believe I've seen that one before.
Twinkle, twinkle.
Observatory. We are the wise men.
The wise people.
The magi.
We're really more like scientists.
Astronomers. We study the stars.
We study the stars so well that when something changes, we notice immediately.
We just noticed a new star in the sky, so we must follow our scientific instincts and find out why there's a new star in the sky.
And now we begin our journey. I guess we're going for a walk.
On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends. And I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again. Going places that I've never been. Seeing things that I may never see again.
Are we there yet?
To get on the road again. On the road again. Like a band of gypsies, we go down the highway. We're the best of friends, insisting that the world keep turning our way. And our way is on the road again. I just can't wait.
Let's look up the local king.
I'm a king!
I am BT! I'm strong!
I'm the best!
Who is this guy?
So, we are here because we are looking for the newly born king.
This child is the king of the Jews.
We observed his star at its rising.
And we have come to honor him.
Excuse me.
Hello, smart boy. What's up?
Hi, your glorious excellency. This is the smart boys. We're hearing a lot of chatter about that Messiah that you've been looking for. Apparently, he's going to be born in Bethlehem underneath a star. This doesn't sound good for you. Sorry for the bad news. I hope you're not mad.
Find the child!
Sure. Okay.
We can do that.
Let's get out of here.
On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends. And I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again. I'm so tired of walking. Places that I've never been. Seeing things that I may never see again.
When we left, Herod just sat around plotting his revenge.
He was threatened by the new king.
But we found Jesus and brought gifts to the special child.
We brought gold.
Dog bones! I mean, frankincense.
And myrrh.
Usually these gifts are for royalty.
Powerful people.
Grown men!
We brought these gifts to a tiny child.
We didn't know exactly what was going on, but we knew he was important.
This good news would turn everything upside down.
Oh, and by the way, we didn't return to that wicked King Herod.
Nope, no way. A dream told us to go to the other way home.
You might say we took the scenic route.
And now we return to watching the stars.
Oh, there's no place like home for the holidays.
Those wise people are really honored by the king God had chosen, brought him presents. This way, the orders of King Herod and made it home safely.
Yes, they were brave and determined. Everyone in the story was, I think. From Mary and Joseph to the shepherds and the magi, they all recognized that the birth of Jesus was going to change the world. Are you feeling safe and sleepy yet? Our story is coming to an end.
Yes, I feel safe and sleepy, but this isn't really the end.
No, why not? It's bedtime. We need to get some sleep.
This is just the beginning. Jesus is born, he grows up, he changes water to wine. He teaches, he heals, he flips tables, he...
Yes, yes, you're right. Jesus' birth is just the beginning. We have a lot to talk about, but it's late. Tonight, let's focus on this one special moment, this one night that brought us Jesus.
Okay, that makes sense. This is a good story.
God's story is unfolding more good news every day, and in the end, all things will be made right. That doesn't mean we won't be afraid along the way, but we can trust that love and justice will have the final word. Speaking of the final word, let's have a final word from Mary, the mother of Jesus. Down to Dixie's sunny shore.
My soul magnifies the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God, my Savior. For you, God, have looked with the favor of the lowliness of your servant. Surely from now all generations will call me blessed. For you, the mighty one, have done great things for me, and holy is your name. Your mercy is for those who fear God from generation to generation. You, O God, have shown strength with your arms. You have scattered the proud in their thoughts of their hearts. You, God, have brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. You have filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. You have helped your servant Israel in remembrance of your mercy, according to the promises you also made to our ancestors, to Abraham and Sarah, and to their descendants forever.
The mountain.